Idiot!
Idiot!
I'm not hungry.
Yeah, just idiot.
Welcome back to Fresh TV. Our next guest, and a man of many talents,
has the sleeve everyone wants,
the body people want,
the church haircut,
ex-Mara Saint,
and future.
That's not a chief.
When I first switched from league to rugby, it was I didn't even really think about playing rugby. It was just, for me, it was getting out of the situation I was in first and foremost. But then when I got over there, started, you know, put on the boots, oh, I'm playing a 15-man game. I wanted to play for the All Blacks.
Sonny Bill Williams playing his first game of rugby for Toulon and making a big impact.
That was probably the big dream. I remember laying awake thinking to myself, man, I don't think I can play this game. It's a bit too tough. Then, you know, I bit off more than I could chew. It doesn't hurt me. A lot of people probably wouldn't have taken that risk to come back and try and, you know, play a whole new game that they never played before. I know, as a sportsman, that's where you test yourself. You take those risks, and some of them pay off, some of them don't. But fortunately, they paid off, and I made the All Blacks, so it was pretty cool. I remember at the start, one of my first meetings, the whole team was there, and I was sitting there, and I was looking, and I was like, damn, these are the boys I used to watch on TV, you know, the All Blacks. I was sitting there, and Ted got up and he said, oh, you know, congratulations, Sonny, you made, yeah, all that kind of stuff. Do you want to stand up and tell us about yourself? So I stood up, and I remember thinking in my head, oh, man, I'm going to try to say something funny to make the boys laugh. So I said something, I forgot what it was, and then it was just silence. You know, no one laughed, so I was like, oh, I remember looking at my eye, this big smirk on his face. It was like, so that was probably my first experience with the All Blacks. It was pretty sad, but now the boys were real welcome. Even though I didn't get much time in the semi-final and final, you know, to be a part of it was a cool feeling and a cool buzz, and to play well in the World Cup was pretty cool as well, so something special. And, I know it made my family pretty proud too. So. Gone pretty well in rugby so far. I want to take it to another level in boxing.
Takes another one!
When I first took it up, I just did it just to kind of experience it. You know, Mundine had been on my case a bit to try out, see how I went. You know, when I first saw it, I just said to myself, man, this is too hard. You know, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't know, gradually I just got the hang of it. I think this just comes back to my Samoan heritage. Love, don't mind to, you know, throw it down now and then. But my mother's side was real good sporting family as well. You know, my pop, Bill Woolsey. William Woolsey, he was pretty famous in his time. Bit of a street brawler, but he was a boxer and a league player. I have, you know, to this day, just walking the streets and that, heaps of old guys always coming up to me, telling me stories about him. So I was fortunate to have probably good sporting genes in that sense. When I'm in boxing mode, the training process is a lot tougher. You know, you're training 6 days a week, training twice a day, 2 days. But what I have to do, I have to add the rugby element in it as well.
So my training routine. What do you wish to come
there? Just visually. Getting the visual aspect down pat before I attack it. You know what I mean?
It's a pretty crazy schedule, but I think for myself, that's what really motivates me, because I've been doing this since I was 17. Kind of brings out the best of me, you know, taking on new challenges and not just proving to everybody else, but proving to my harshest critic, myself, that I can do it, you know. It's really complemented my rugby game, you know. Proof's in the pudding, you know, the last 2 years in rugby, I've played some pretty good footy, and I think I put that down to the fact that I'm doing something different that's pushing my body. Just got to keep training hard and ticking those small boxes, because, you know, then at the end of the day, the bigger picture kind of falls into place. If I only could make a deal with God. Yeah, my mom came to one fight. She cried. And that'll be that's the last time she'll come to a fight. So, but my old man's always there in the corner, you know, nervous as, always outside. I think he's about 20 smokes before I go outside, before I go into the ring. So, yeah, got a real supportive family in that sense.
What combination from SPW? And he's got Tillman. Is he going to go down the first round?
It's pretty cool, pretty special. Some, you know, that I can look back on when I'm finished. Whatever I do in life, I want to be firstly good at it, you know, and I want to be successful, and I want to be the best at what I do, you know? I know sometimes you got to have a medium, you know, and you got to enjoy yourself a little bit, but I find that, you know, after 2 or 3 days when I'm not doing anything, I just go for a run or you know, play touch with the boys, go down and play some tag, show my steps, my skills. Nah. You know my skills, Sonny
Bill, always, hey. What did that come being the most searched image on?
Sorry about that. Nah, I don't know, because I don't read the media, man. I gave up on that a while ago. So you want to be a rock superstar? Picking up newspapers and doing that kind of stuff, because what I find, you know, with my experiences, they can build you up, but at the same time, they're quick to take you down, you know. So I think you just got to do what makes you happy, you know. Yeah, man, they're hanging out at my house.
Yeah.
Stalkers. I don't know, I think those people need to get a life, eh? And leave me alone. Women's Day. I don't want to be in this magazine. But, nah, that's all good. Just comes with the territory, I guess, you know. I don't know, I'm pretty simple in that sense. Just roll with the punches, you know. As long as my family's all right, as long as, you know, my mom's living a good lifestyle, then I'm sweet, you know, I'm fine. What am I most proud of? Definitely being able to look after my mom. Look after my mom and help up my family, you know, wherever I can. That's probably the proudest thing that I'm... proudest thing that I've done in my life.
And you know you're fresh when you're wearing a jacket on a hot summer day.
Oh. You know you're fresh when you got 5 plates of food and you're eating in the car park.
And you know you're fresh when you have to say your mum's stuff.
Conjure, conjure.
Deh.
Conjure, see I'm PC.
Okay. Sorry.
Idiot.
You know you're brown and around when?
You kick from here
to Samoa,
to Fiji,
to Rarotonga,
then Furupos,
and then in the palm tree.
In the palm tree.
What we're doing here today is Lalanga Mai. It's just basically market day showcasing our island arts and crafts, our great performances, island food. Our Nguyen Mama is up there on stage, so they're definitely someone to look out for.
We actually come from just down the road here on Valiant Street, Mangere. We're always bunched up in the garage jamming music, so it's good to be out here performing for the local crowd. Mr. Slow Jam, bring the beat back, so we
can jam, jam, jam to our favorite song. I'm just looking after my mum's stall, stuff that she crocheted. Our day's going good. We had some good entertainment and a lot of people come through acknowledging skills, so it's pretty cool.
The Coconut crew came out and sang a beautiful choir song, and I just think the sense of everyone being here together is really nice.
We just came down here to support the kaupapa with Lalanga Mai.
You know you're fresh
when you jam on a pedestrian.
You got my mind made up and I won't turn back.
Whatever. 1, 2, 3,
OMB!
And you know you're fresh when you're wearing a jacket on a hot summer day.
Oh. You know you're fresh when you got 5 plates of food and you're eating in the car park.
And you know you're fresh when you have to say your mum's stuff.
Valley and boy.
It is very important for the young ones to see the handcraft and the weaving so they can learn heaps when they grow up and they keep the ta'onga of their grandparents.
Thank you very much. Bye.
What's up? We're the Valiant Boys and you've been here with us at the Lalanga Mai Festival, Mangere Arts Centre, and we're here all day keeping it fresh.
Boom, 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 boom
Joe in the sunny weather. Yeah. Got a lover, having a family reunion. And seen her on our wild house, the fam's who's.
Right, everyone, have a look at his face. Tell me he does not look like that guy from Smallville.
I don't know.
He does, eh? Superman. Wannabe Superman.
Who do you reckon Krisnan Inu looks like Steve Kinney?
Oh, wait. Now I do.
Yes!
Oh, you got it!
Just though.
He's just a show off. Because we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow.
Take it slow. Oh, oh, oh. This time. Ja!
Justice!
Justice! I'm the king.
King of what?
King Justice. King Justice.
Welcome back, Freshies. Knowing your roots is like
knowing your locker rooms.
We play a lot of pranks, especially to this man here on 151, Lewis Brown. I think he's a pretty boy. He's got the biggest nose I've ever come across, and he's got the worst dress style and dress sense I've ever come across as well. So
we're going to play Christmas tree with Louis' shoes.
Everything that gets pranked, even if it's not me, I get blamed for it all the time.
Because most times it's true, as you can see. And look, he's trying to pull a prank on me and I'm standing right here.
Who's this one?
Dumbo. Oh, Princess.
This is Princess. Oh, yeah,
this is Princess Johnson.
Because he's very precious. And he won't blame me because we stick together and he thinks that I'm on his side because we're the only boys from the North Shore.
Nick Manor.
And look at these surfboards. How are these for shoes? Who's these? Sam Lassi. Look at these. 16s.
You look like Frodo.
Look at these.
Frodo with Essex.
Manu Vatiwai. This is a locker here. Ho, 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 ho. Look at that. This is our locker.
Has he got some? I'm taking one. Blue's my favourite colour. Thanks, Manu.
Know your roots, where your nana is wrong and I'm right. In the Pacific Islands, we love our animals. But my point of the moral is that Lady Gaga isn't the only one that loves to wear what she eats. Turtle keyrings, turtle patterns, turtle tattoos, turtle shell bracelets and hair clips. Turtle, turtle, turtle everywhere. But why the significance? This is the legend of the turtle and the shark based on the song Lau Me. Deep in the Pacific Ocean lay the islands of Samoa. In Savai, a mother named Fonuea and her son were living in a poor village. They had no food, no water, and no Facebook. Out of the blueness, a message was sent to Fonuea that her son had to be sacrificed to the King Maliatoa Whainga's feast. So Fonuea and her son made their way to the king. Are we on the same page? No? Yeah, turn the page, man. Somehow they got lost in transition and ended up in Tutuila, where a very generous chief called Letuli lived. Fonuea explained her situation and Letuli felt, you know, a bit stank for them, so then he brought them into his house, hooking them up with food, clothes, beds and everything they never got back in their poor village. Of course they enjoyed this hospitality for a very long time until the day came when King Maliatoa Whainga decided to give up on eating the people of his kingdom. It was time for Fonuea and son to return home. They wanted to thank Chief Letuli for hiding them and saving the son from being eaten from the ugly king. So they jumped into the ocean to travel the Pacific Ocean, spreading the news about the great and very generous Chief Letuli. Big ups, bro. As they leapt into the ocean, Fonuea turned into a turtle and his son turned into a shark. To this day, in the village of Waitongi, if you sing the song of Fonuea from the cliffs, a turtle and shark would rise to the surface. Remember, this is a legend, so we believe it's true even though we haven't even seen it. Please don't try this at home. Hey, auntie, stop that. Know your roots!
Win a 222 on the brand new Virgin Samoa plane to Apia.
Check it out, pretty flash, hey, look at that! Nice uniforms too. All you have to do is let us know how many golden coconuts have appeared in this series of Fresh. And you could be staying right here, Aggie Grace Hotel, check it out. Go to our website for more info. But for Te Lava Virgin Samoa, we love to you!
This is our Fresh Unplugged in our sheds.
Nah, here's the real one.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't the honeymoon. We passed the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehave, and you make your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. Though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow, yeah. 'Cause we're ordinary people, yeah. Maybe we should take it slow, take it slow. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah. This time we'll take it slow, take it slow. Time will take it slow, take it slow. Maybe we'll live and learn, maybe we'll crash and burn. Maybe you'll stay, maybe you'll leave, maybe you'll return. Maybe we'll never find, maybe you won't survive. Maybe we'll grow, you'll never know. Baby, you and I, we're just ordinary people. Don't know which way to go, hey, hey, 'cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow, take it slow. Oh, oh, oh. This time we'll take it slow, take it slow. Oh, oh, oh.
It's been a long day hosting Fresh, and we're just having a little session in the spa, as we do after every training session and after every game.
I hope you like our Fresh movements and acts today.
Be sure to join us next week on our last show of Fresh. I know my family will be on the show, Arden and Pati.
Big shout out to all the Warrior members and Auto Z. You know, everyone that's part of the Warriors crew, big shout out to yous and
especially the families. Boys. Thanks for joining us. You know you're fresh when you're in the spa and you're washing your clothes.
What?
Tell them for love, welcome to Fresh. You chilling with your boy Spawn Breezy.
You know you're fresh when you use your socks as earmuffs.
I would love to touch his stuff, but I'm scared. Just, I hate it.
Shot! New Zealand on air for the pingers.